Hi everybody, welcome to another edition of Inside Elite Fitness. I'm Sean Woodland, he's Tommy Marquez. This is the final week of the Open, and every year we have been gifted with thrusters. Why is this year going to be any different?
Well, thrusters are the quintessential CrossFit movement, but if there's one thing about Dave Castro, once you think you have him figured out, he likes to kind of flip the playing board and just switch it up on you, keep everyone guessing. So I'm not saying that we're not going to see it, but I would not be surprised if thrusters didn't show up.
And last year we had a chance to not have thrusters, but everybody voted to have thrusters, and we kept the streak alive. Maybe it's the same deal here in 2019. Once again, it's going to be an international affair as far as the announcements are concerned, but the big one is going on in Miami, Florida. Clash of Champions, Matt Fraser and Tia Toomey. Plus, there's going to be a matchup between Brenda Castro and Leah Schmidt. We'll have more on that here in a little bit. But that is being put on by the Wadapalooza people. If you have a chance to go to that, do it, because they put on a first-class event down there.
I mean, what more could you ask for? You have the two reigning fittest men and women on Earth, five titles between them. It's going to be outdoors in Miami, underneath the lights. I'm stoked to be out there calling the event as well, so it's going to be a fun week.
This final week will ultimately determine who winds up at the CrossFit Games. We still have some sanctioned events to go after the Open, but let's set the table here and look at right now. We're going to start with the women. Who would be in line for the invitations from these sanctioned events if the Open ended at this 5 minutes? So in Dubai, Bethany Shadburn would get it. Taylor Stride would get it for Wadapalooza. Mia Ackerland would go from Fittest in Cape Town, and then Maddie Sturt from the Australian CrossFit Championship, and then Turi Helgadottir, we talked a lot about that, what she did on that final event in Strength and Depth, she would get that invite. But let's focus on Wadapalooza, because Taylor Stride finished ninth, but the woman who holds the key to this whole thing is Colleen Foch.
Yeah, Colleen Foch is no doubt the linchpin here. She finished sixth at Wadapalooza, and as of right now, she's the second to last athlete in above that top 20 qualifying cut line. So if Foch, for some reason, in week number five, slips below that cut line, then suddenly she takes the invite from Wadapalooza through the backfill. But if she manages to stay on top, it keeps going on down the line to Taylor Stride at ninth. So she better be sending some well wishes Colleen Foch's way.
Yeah, no bigger fan of Colleen Foch than Taylor Stride here in 19.5. Let's go over to the men's side and do the same thing there. Right now for Dubai, it's Roman Krennikoff, because Willy George has separated himself for the fittest in France. So Krennikoff looks good there. Pat Vellner won Wadapalooza. He would get that invite as of now. Sean Sweeney, same story with Fittest in Cape Town. And then the Australia CrossFit Championship, James Newbery gets that. Bronislava Lankiewicz will get the one from Strength and Depth. Again, it all goes back to Miami and Wadapalooza. Patrick Vellner not out of the running for a spot in the top 20, and then that invite at Wadapalooza starts to get passed down.
Yeah, but as of right now, he's not above that cut line, so that means he would walk away with the invite from Wadapalooza. But as we've seen Pat start to mount a comeback up the leaderboard, if he manages to get above that cut line, that's going to get passed down to third place Noah Olsen, who's also below that cut line. If by some magic Noah and Pat get above, well, then you know what? Strap up, because the Big Red Express is going to Madison.
Yeah, Drew Wayman would get the bid there. But so there's a lot riding then on what's going on here in the final week. Not only with the sanctioned events and who's going to get those invites, but now also the national championship races will determine ultimately who goes to the games in a couple of spots. And we'll start on the women's side, two close races, one in Sweden and the other one is in Mexico.
Yeah, starting with Sweden, you have to look at the race between Camilla Salmonsson-Hellman and Michaela Norman. Now, Salmonsson-Hellman is the very first athlete below the cut line right now for one of those top 20 qualifying spots. She's also in a close race with Norman for the fittest in Sweden. Now, for some reason, she manages to lose that race to Norman, and Norman pushes ahead of her. Then that's two opportunities lost, because she would not be able to move up overall in that qualifying top 20 spot, and she'd lose the national championship race. You hope that doesn't happen, and there's a way that both of them could make their way up, but it's a very tight race. And then you go to Mexico and the race between Brenda Castro and Leah Schmidt. Only a few points separate them right now, and we get to see them actually go to Miami and throw down head to head for this final week of the Open for the announcements. And neither of them are in any kind of position to move up into a top 20 qualifying spot. So the only way they're going to get to the games is through the Mexican National Championship. And it's a close race. So we get to see this play out live in front of everyone watching on Thursday.
Yeah, that'd be great. On the men's side over in Switzerland, two games veterans are battling it out for the fittest in Switzerland title. That's Adrian Moonviller, who right now has a slight lead on Lucas Eschlinger, but this one now comes down to the final week between the two of them.
Yeah, two buddies and two known CrossFit Games athletes from Switzerland are right next to each other on the worldwide leaderboard, and they're also right next to each other in their country leaderboard for Switzerland. And right now, As it stands, based on where they finished worldwide, their only chance through the Open is to win this national champion. So it's going to come down to this final week with just a few points separating. And then the other one is going to have to look towards one of these sanctioned events to hopefully kind of nab another invite to the CrossFit Games.
But the most exciting national title race is in Poland on the men's side, where four guys have a legitimate shot of winning this thing.
I think we all took a vote coming into the Open at which national champion race would be the Poland. Most exciting. Unanimous for Poland. But you have to look at the leaderboard. There's four male athletes that are all within 2 points of each other. Any one of them could walk away with it by week five. But beyond that, three of those athletes also are within a shot of earning one of those top 20 qualifying spots too. So if by some mix of order that the bottom guy manages to get on top while everyone else still does good worldwide, we could have four athletes from Poland making it through the Open to the CrossFit Games, which would be unprecedented.
Now, the final week is going to be a lot of fun to watch. One big thing we want to tell you guys is we have a new website. If you like what we're doing, you want us to keep doing it, and you want to support the cause, go to InsideElitefitness.com, and you can help keep this train rolling down the tracks. Good luck with 19.5. That's going to do it for us for today. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Inside Elite Fitness, there. You can also follow us on Instagram and on Facebook, and you can subscribe to our podcast, Talking Elite Fitness, on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, on Spotify, or wherever you listen to your favorite podcast. For Tommy Marquez, I'm Sean Woodland. Good luck with 19.5, and we will see you next week.